Hey everyone, it's Matt. So a few weeks ago, you might remember that I did review the Bentley 6-in-1 trike. That was all fully put together and we just showed you how it worked. Now I'm gonna show you how to install it. This does come with an assembly guide, but you might find this video helpful if you're more of a visual learner. So let's get to it. Things do come partially installed. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're going to install the front wheel to the base here. And it just slides in through a little hole at the bottom. So it just slides on like this and clips in place. The next piece are the handlebars that we're going to put right up here. You're gonna have to push this down with a little bit of force, and then we're going to affix this screw with an Allen key to put things into place. So just one thing to be aware of here is that you do have a little bit of a tight window to work with, and you'll have to sort of maneuver the screw into there. And once that's done, you can close this lid down. So I'm just gonna finish that now. Okay folks, next up in the trike installation is the seat itself. Now the seat does come fully pre-assembled. I would recommend just strapping all the harnesses together so that they're not in your way. This looks like a pretty simple thing to do. On the underside of the seat, just right here, there's a little part that it clips into here. And then all we'll have to do is sit it on there, and then underneath the bike there is a little place for us to put one of these in and then to tighten with an Allen key. So that's my next step. All right, so I have the seat basically sitting on the mount right now. You do have to do this next step with the screw upright because of the fact that this isn't really sitting on anything strong. And so if you tilt it on its side, it's gonna fall off, and obviously the shape of the seat will make it difficult to do it and screw this in unless it is sitting upright. So that's the next step. You'll basically just have to stick it into a little hole at the bottom and then tighten it with an Allen key. Before I stick this upright and tighten it, I just wanted to show you where on the bike frame this was. And so, like I said, it just sits in and you screw it upright and tighten it with the Allen key, and the seat should be in place at that point. The next piece in our assembly journey was actually one of my favorite features of the trike, which I showed you, and it was these safety harnesses. Now, this is great for your child that's in that 18-month to 2-year range and is just kind of learning excuse me, the ins and outs of this tricycle. So it's pretty simple. Make sure the red side is down for whichever side you're installing, and it just slides into there. So from the top down, I thought I'd show you that this is done, just so you know. This doesn't actually clip in together. It does require a bit of force, so you'll need both hands, but it doesn't come apart, and it doesn't actually make a clicking noise or a clipping noise when this is fixed into place, but you know that you can remove it because of the red tab at the bottom. You just have to pull the tab out and then slide it back up the way that you put it in. Okay, our next step is the canopy. So the canopy installs into the safety harness guard here that I just installed. It also does come with this additional zippered piece here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just actually gonna zip in that zippered piece to the front here, and then we're gonna install the whole thing at once. All right, so the whole zippered canopy is put together, and I just wanted to show you how it clipped in. So you'll see these buttons here, and you'll see the little holes that they slide into on the safety guards. So that's really it. You really just have to push it up from the top until it clicks in, and then you're set to go. Things are really starting to come together nicely, and the installation really hasn't been difficult at this point. You'd think that something like this would be a lot harder, but it's actually been pretty simple and pretty straightforward so far. Your next step is completely optional, but it always is helpful for the kids to have a little storage. It's the basket. So the basket does come mostly together. This is the bottom end here. You just have to take the screw while you're installing it into the catch here, and make sure that it sits properly on the little groove. Okay, and once that's sitting there, you just have to tighten it from underneath with this little nut. Next up, we've got the push bars, which are gonna go on the back of the bike there. And we've got two pieces here. So we've got this little Y-shaped fork. This is the first piece that's going to go in. And then we have the rest of the push bar that's going to go above this piece here. One other thing that's included, again, this is completely optional, is this little storage basket that's included. I do call this the dad basket because this is where I would hold diapers, wipes, snacks, those sorts of things. All right, so let's get to this. Okay, here on the back of the bike, there is only one way to install this. You have to make sure that this red piece is facing outward as you push in. There's a couple holes here again, and then there are clips that this thing will slot into and fit around. And then you'll have to tighten this up. Just be sure to wiggle it into place until you hear it click, just like that. And then press this up to lock it. With this push bar, it's got this one little button in the back here and two holes that accompany it. So you can really only install it the one way. If you install it the wrong way, it's just going to slide up and down. So I'm going to get started on that. Okay, and same as before, push it into place until you hear a click. Just like that. So now our push bar is installed as well. Okay, I purposely saved one tough bit for last, and that's the rear wheels. Now, the assembly instructions actually show that the entire body comes installed, so the rear wheels are actually installed to the chassis itself, but in the model I had here, the rear wheels were not installed. So just in case your model comes without the rear wheels installed, it's a pretty simple thing to do here. So basically, this is where your rear wheel is going to sit. And you're going to sit your rear wheel in like this. You can use that to lock it into place if you want. I have it sitting a little bit crooked, but I'll straighten it out because all you have to do is you just take this piece here and you're going to slide it through the wheel. So you're going to slide it through the hole there and feed it in through the middle. And then you just have to take the nuts here and tighten them into place. So the wheel will just sit like this. Like I said, it does lock using this plastic lock here. It'll go like this. It does come with a little wrench if you want to tighten this into place as well. Before we get to the final step of installation, I just wanted to show you one more thing while I've got this upside down, and this is the middle footrests. So the middle footrest does come fully installed. It can be removed if you just take a Phillips head screwdriver and unscrew this compartment here. Everything will just kind of pull out and fall apart. There's a pin inside that holds this together, but again, you can just pull the pin. This is really simple. It actually looks like it's a lot harder to operate than it actually is. You just have to put some force down and fan out the footrests. And this is for your younger child or if they just want to sit with the middle footrest while you push them. And the last thing that I'm going to show you here are these footrests. So these are optional. These actually go into the seat itself. So I'm going to flip this right side up and show you where they go in. Okay, our last step are these footrests. So these footrests are conveniently marked left and right, depending on which side you're going to install them in. There is really no wrong way to do this because the seats are contoured at the bottom, specifically with the slots for these. So these will just slide in like such. And that's it. And the last thing for you to do is basically just flare your back wheels with the Bentley logo. And you're set to go. So this is a very, very, very easy installation, to be honest with you. This really only took, putting the video together and everything probably took about 30 minutes. But honestly, following these instructions and knowing what's already pre-installed, this should really only take you about 15 minutes or so. So much of this comes pre-installed. The canopy's already put together. The seat's already put together. Most of the bottom chassis is already put together. With the exception possibly of the back wheels. Now, every other installation video I've seen, as well as the assembly instructions, seem to show that the back wheels do come installed. So I might have just had a demo model here where I had to put the back wheels in. But again, it's not really a big deal. It really only took me about 2 minutes once I figured out what I had to do. And this thing is now ready to go out on the road and be tested. So this is an installation for the Bentley 6-in-1 trike, fully installed. So this is everything that you need, everything you need from the first step, and things can be stripped off as time goes on, and it will it will strip down into a tricycle. So if you want to see more of that, check the actual review video itself where I take you through the stages and what things look like when things have been pulled off. In the meantime, I'm Matt. Please subscribe to this channel for more videos like this, and we'll see you next time. Take care.